Are you in the market to buy a new home or pay off an existing mortgage? Watch this video so that you can understand how you can pay yourself the principal and interest you would have paid the bank. My name is Darius.
And I'm Carmen.
And we help entrepreneurs and high achievers own their own lifestyle. So make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you can be notified every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of new videos.
And also check us out on Patreon, because the information that we are going to cover with you right now has already been addressed in our Patreon community. And we go through all of the numbers and break everything out so that you can see the process of using a whole life insurance policy to either pay off your mortgage or to pay for a house.
We are very familiar with the financial minutiae that goes along with purchasing a new home or paying off that mortgage. So I promise by the end of this video, you'll at least know exactly how you can use a whole life insurance policy to make that purchase or recapture that interest back to yourself using a whole life insurance policy. Comment below if you are in the market for a new home or if you're looking to pay off your mortgage.
From a traditional financial standpoint, whenever you buy a home, you are either going to finance it through the bank for about 15 to 30 years, mm-hmm. or you just pay cash for it and you don't have to worry about the principal and interest that you would be paying a bank. So what we thought that we would do with this video to be helpful to you is to break down each scenario, the numbers that are involved, and then bring in the whole life insurance policy at the end so that you can make an informed decision to see if this is something that you even want to think about for your financial purposes. Mm-hmm. So I'll break down financing a mortgage. And with my example, I'm gonna use a $200,000 mortgage at 5% for 30 years. So when we break down the numbers, and I have everything written down here, the monthly payment is gonna be about $1,571 a month. The annual payment is gonna be $18,860. And then over the course of the 30 years, you are gonna pay $565,813. And again, I just found this, I used a mortgage calculator online, so you can play with the numbers however you choose. Those are just the numbers that I chose for this video. So in this case, what we want to talk about with financing a home is that sometimes as consumers, we just tend to look at the monthly payment. And so we go, okay, if our budget is $1,600 a month, $1,571 fits right in my budget, and this is amazing because I can afford this house. So the one thing that we really don't take into consideration, I would say generally, right, just generally speaking, is that for 30 years, you are paying over $500,000 for this home, and it only cost, and the value of the home at the time of purchase was $200,000. Mm-hmm. So you're paying $300,000 more just to be able to have the ownership of the home. So it all depends on exactly what it is that you want to do. But again, we want to be real, do the math, show you the numbers so that you understand exactly what you're doing when it comes to having a mortgage. Because sometimes we find a lot of our clients would prefer to just pay cash and save up the money so that they're not spending so much in interest to the mm-hmm. banks.
Now, there's a ton of things that goes into the purchase of a home that we are not talking about. Mm-hmm. We're just talking about the financing piece, the actual mortgage and the principal that you pay, the mortgage itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no taxes, no HOA, furniture, none of that. We're strictly just talking about a 30-year mortgage for this example. So for this, like I said, I just laid out the numbers for financing a house through the bank, mm-hmm. and then Darius will do cash, right?
Yeah, so when it comes to cash, let's say the house again is $200,000. Over the next 5 years, you save up $40,000, or the next 10 years, you save $20,000. Mm-hmm. Whatever is most comfortable for you, you save that over a long period of time and you pay cash for that house. Mm-hmm. Now, when you pay cash for the house, you don't have to worry about paying anyone interest. You just pay cash for the house and whatever other closing fees that are associated with it, you're done. You wipe your hands clean and you walk away, and now you have this house. Mm-hmm. So far, we've been through two scenarios. One, you finance it through the bank at 5%. By financing it through the bank, you paid over $300,000 in interest. Mm-hmm. The second scenario, we pay cash, where we saved $40,000 for 5 years to pay cash to purchase this home. Now, in both scenarios, you still financed it. You financed it through the bank and you financed it by saving money every single month. That's money that wasn't in motion or out there working for you for you to earn any interest on those finances.
Yeah, because typically when you think about it with that breakdown, you're either paying someone the interest or you're losing your ability to earn interest when you pay cash. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to make sure that we broke down both of those scenarios first before we threw the whole life insurance policy at you so that you can make the best decision for yourself. Because like Darius said, if you're already going to finance this purchase through the bank or through yourself because you're saving money monthly, mm-hmm. wouldn't you rather have all of that principal and interest for yourself as opposed to it going away from you? So with the next scenario, when we talk about a whole life insurance policy, we're just going to show you how to treat yourself the exact same way you would a bank, but use your policy to fund the purchase of the mortgage or to pay off the mortgage and continue paying yourself the interest.
Right. So the only thing you do is combine both scenarios together and use a whole life insurance policy. You already have the habit of saving $40,000 every single year. Make this $40,000 your premium.
Yeah.
And put this into a whole life insurance policy, and instead of borrowing from the bank, you borrow from the whole life insurance policy, the cash value, and you purchase your home. Now, what you do with this scenario is the monthly payments that you make back to the insurance company for your mortgage, you're recapturing all that interest that would have gone away from you or would have benefited another family versus yours.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you can use the exact same numbers that I just broke down. So you'd pay yourself $1,500 a month mm-hmm. for that mortgage, but you're paying yourself back into your banking system. And although it may take a few years, we're talking maybe 5 or 6 years for you to have this money available in your policy, mm-hmm. it would have taken you the same amount of time to just save it outright anyway. So at least now you have some insurance coverage to CYA, and then two, you have some cash value that you can utilize to finance your lifestyle. So for us, we find this to be a win-win scenario where we have our cake and we can eat it too. Mm-hmm. And it really makes it amazing because not only is our house financed through our banking system, we're also the payers. So we're now paying ourselves back all the principal and interest that we would have been paying to the banks.
Right. So let's think about this. If I financed it through my whole life insurance policy and then I paid my insurance policy, the principal and interest I would have paid to the bank, I have all the cash for that house.
I have it all back.
You have it all back.
Which plus means interest.
Which means the cost of the house is a positive $300,000 plus
positive $565,813.
Plus the interest that you're earning inside your whole life insurance policy.
At 4%.
Yes, exactly. So put yourself in a position to have win-win situations. You finance the home and you have all the cash back so that it can continue to benefit your family throughout your lifestyle, because your lifetime, because the house still appreciates.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, we hope it appreciates.
Yes.
And you have the home and the cash.
Yes, and that's an amazing position to be in. Talk about control. Mm-hmm. And sometimes when we make specific investments, the control is better than the rate of return in some instances. Right. And now in this, you're controlling both assets or both phases of the transaction, which makes it amazing for you and just creates so much flexibility. Because again, think if you finance the home through a bank and you happen to have a rough month, the bank isn't going to be too lenient or flexible with you and saying, hey, can I get you next month? It ain't happening. So you have to make sure that, again, control and freedom are the things that we're going for and the things that we teach about just financial liberation and financial literacy. So we also realize that there's so many different ways that you can finance a house, but we wanted to just talk about three ways in particular going around the themes of being a debtor, saver, or a wealth creator. Mm-hmm. So we talked about the debtor, we talked about the saver, and the wealth creator is using your whole life insurance policy to own the home and get all of the cash back.
Another thing that I want to address really quickly is the fact that we've been coming across clients that are adamant about paying their mortgage off. And what they've been doing is taking every bit of disposable income and throwing it at their mortgage. Now, the thing that I want to say when it comes to this is when you put that extra payment of disposable income to work in paying off your mortgage, in the event of an emergency, how do you get that money back?
You don't.
You don't, because it's in your house.
Yeah.
It's really hard to get money out of your house unless you get you a HELOC or some other form of loan collateralizing your home. Mm-hmm. So really think about this when it comes to your purpose for paying your mortgage off more aggressively, because there's other things that you can use the money for so that it can make you more money in the future.
Yeah, and to be fair, the reason why people are chunking money away at their mortgage is because they want to pay it off quicker. Mm-hmm. But again, think about it. What we were just talking about is you're going to pay an extra $300,000 in interest. So do you just happen to have $300,000 laying around that will help you pay off this mortgage sooner? I wouldn't think so. And I would think if you think about it from different terms, you would want to take that $300,000 in just interest and use it to work for you. Mm-hmm. So instead of chunking every little dollar, extra dollar that you can at your mortgage, take that extra money and start a policy that can grow you the cash value that you need to pay off the policy more aggressively once your cash value grows. Mm-hmm. And then also, again, you still have the death benefit, you still have the cash value working, and now you've created a cash flowing asset that you can tap into on an annual basis. Mm-hmm. Because when you continue to pay cash, throw cash at that mortgage, you never see that money again, and there goes your liquidity. Mm-hmm. So the name of the game is all about liquidity. Yes, we get that you want to pay your mortgage off sooner, and you can totally do that using your policy. But keep more of that hard-earned money that you're working for and do something more productive with it than just throwing it at debt.
Remember, this does not include insurance, taxes, furniture, or any other expenses that come with the purchase of a home. But just remember, by controlling the financing piece of it through your whole life insurance policy, you can reuse those funds to make purchases like insurance, taxes, and furniture.
How about that? You can fund all of that through your whole life insurance policy and get all of it back.
That's the name of the game. So if you want to see exactly how this is broken down, check out our Patreon page where we go over exactly how you recapture a $200,000 house using your whole life insurance policy.
Mm-hmm. In addition to what Darius was saying, if you really like to see the numbers and the breakdown, then definitely check out our Patreon community, because we take all of the information that we share here on YouTube and we put it on Patreon, where we show you illustrations and we show you how you're taking money from one place to the other and paying it all of it off. Mm-hmm. So especially if you have an existing policy, we'd love for you to be a part of our community so that you can make sure you're maximizing your policy to accomplish your financial goals.
If you like this video, let us know by liking it, subscribing, and sharing it with your friends.
And what do we do here on the Wealth Nation channel? We own our own lifestyle.
Or someone else will.